Rubel is, you know, who Rubel is as a person. I want to know what made you do this beautiful work. I would call you a healer. You know, you are healing the entire world with your art. So how did it come to you? And yes, please tell me more about this Rubel who's sitting, who's very gorgeous.
Thank you. And so are you. And so nice to see you. And I'm so happy that we connected and we are doing this today. Rubel, if I define myself, I would say Rubel is someone very simple at heart, very hardworking, someone who doesn't believe in giving up so easily. And one motto of my life that I always follow, and I also teach everyone that I'm connected to, that I never give up in life. You know, failure or success, you will only know once you've given it a try. So ek bar koshish karke zarur dekho, उसमें सफलता मिलेगी या नहीं मिलेगी वो बाद की बात है, बट पछतावा नहीं रहेगा कि आपने उसको करने के लिए वो पहला स्टेप नहीं लिया. सो ऑलवेज गिव इन योर बेस्ट, डोंट वरी अबाउट द सक्सेस और फेलियर ऑफ योर वर्क, बिकॉज देर इज नो डेफिनेशन टू सक्सेस दैट एनीवन कैन डिस्क्राइब. सो ऑलवेज गिव इट योर ट्राई एंड देन यू नो लेट थिंग्स फॉल इन प्लेस फॉर यू, बट यू मस्ट डेफिनेटली ट्राई. कोशिश करने के पहले give up nahi karna hai. That is what I would define myself as, and I think I've done that in past so many years that, you know, I've been very I'm like a go-getter. I love challenges. I work hard, and I tell all my team that if you want to be motivated by your teacher, then you have to follow what she believes in. And I think my team is great, and they're my family. So
since Rubel, you said about challenges, my next question is, you know, हर रोज हमें challenges मिलते हैं, you know, लगता है camera के आगे लगता है, success story के बाद आगे लगता है कि wow, what a beautiful, you know, achievement. But आपकी क्या challenges होते हैं, you know, daily, you know, you are a mother, you're a wife, you're a daughter-in-law, you're a daughter. How do you manage so many things? What are your challenges?
You know, challenges, even when you're not a mother, daughter, or a teacher, or madam, or ma'am, or didi, whatever everybody calls me, you still have challenges in life. Struggle, challenges, hard work, these are part of our life. We faced a lot of challenges. Honestly, you know, I believe Rome wasn't built in a day. Overnight, koi bhi star nahi banta hai. And then again, I would say there is no definition to being a star or being successful, because anyone who does good work, according to me, is successful in their life. We faced, because we work mostly in the slums and we work mostly in the villages and rural side of the country. So, wahan pe challenges bahut zyada hai. The mindset of people is very different. To, you know, make them understand about certain things, it takes a little longer because exposure inko नॉर्मल शहरों के लोगों से थोड़ा कम है. दे आर वेरी सिंपल, दे आर मोस्ट अमेजिंगली लविंग पीपल, एंड यू नो दे वेलकम यू विद ओपन आर्म्स, एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई से यू नो विद द लव एंड रिस्पेक्ट दैट दे गिव मी, दैट हैज मेड मी गोइंग फ्रॉम वन एरिया टू अनदर टू अनदर टू अनदर, एंड टुडे वी आर वर्किंग इन मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. सो आई गेस चैलेंजेस आर अ पार्ट ऑफ आवर लाइफ, बट एज आई सेड दैट यू हैव टू फेस देम विद डिग्निटी, यू हैव टू फेस देम विद बीइंग स्ट्रांग, एंड एज अ वुमन यू हैव advantages and disadvantages also, but I would take that as an advantage. And somebody asked me a few days back that would you ever want to be born as a man, and I said no, I would always want to be born as a woman, and maybe always want to be born as Rubel Nagi, because you know, I chose the life of service as a very young age, thanks to my parents, because we were exposed to a lot of simplicity in life when I was growing up. And we met so many different people from so many different parts of the country. Every 2 years when dad got posted to a new area, we met new set of people, ate different food, spoke different language. You know, their culture, their rehen sehen, everything was so different and so versatile. And I think India is the only country in the world which has this beauty, you know. So I'm a proud Indian, and challenges are a part of life, and we must stay calm while addressing them, because no one's life is going to go just very smoothly, and no one's life is going to have only challenges and ups and downs. So when you have down, you have to come up also, and always remember that when you're up, there will be time in life where you'll suddenly come down, and that is the time you have to keep calm, stay stable, think positive and say, okay, you know, this is not going to last. So work towards going forward again. So I think that is something we have to keep in our mind always.
When you started this 15 years back, you know, where did this come from? Made slums look beautiful. And, you know, when you see those people, you see the colors in their eyes. You know, you see the happiness in their eyes.
Started work over 10 years. But on paper from 2011, but uske pehle bhi, I think 2007-8 se my journey in social work started with my first art camp with the NGO named Pratham. And unke jo founder hai, he's been a guiding force towards my social work as well. And I'm very thankful to him. So I guess that's where the journey started. And when you talk about slums, the main aim of Ruben Nagi Art Foundation is educating through art. And our mission is to see every child in school and learning well. That is the main aim of R&Art Foundation. We have different initiatives, like we launched RONNAK, Learn to Earn, Read and Write India, Skill India Initiative. Like that, we have a lot of initiatives that we launch every year, 2 years, 3 years, depending on the scale of the initiative. Misal Mumbai, that you are talking about, the beautification of the slum started in 2018, January. And within a year, I think 13 months, it became Misal India, because we actually thought that Mumbai mein itne slums hain, Maharashtra mein, Pune mein, Nagpur mein, so many places you have slums. So hum Bombay se hi nahi nikal payenge. But I think it was the scale of the project with 4 months of time. It just went on a national level, and we started work in most of the areas that Ruben Nagi Art Foundation was already working. Hum jin gaon mein already hamare jo balwadis thi, skill centers the, we started transforming those areas also through Misal Initiative. That, you know, we talk about hygiene, we talk about sanitation, we talk about saving water, we talk about plastic, no use of plastic, let's beat plastic pollution and, you know, minimize the use of plastic. So, ye dheere dheere, like earlier, you know, Hina, when I would go to visit a village, yahan pe abhi beautification aur misal ka kaam shuru karenge. So, people would give you water in plastic cups. Or fruity. Fruity and thumbs up is something that Coca-Cola is something which most of the villages we get.
True.
So they would give you in plastic cups. And True. You know, I think one of those days when they were giving plastic cups, I was like, you know what, now I think only Balwadi and Skill Center is not something we are going to restrict ourselves to. We will go into the replicating the entire Misal Mumbai model into every area that we are working, and so many more then got added on. So we started that, replicating that into every village, started beautifying, did cleanliness drives, women workshops, youth career counseling. We started employing people. They started coming and learning in our skill center. Number increased as we started the beautification. So that is when we did the cleanliness drive, they started understanding ki, okay, hame plastic ke cup mein nahin, hame kaanch ke ya steel ke glass mein dena hai. So, you know, how in those few months, when I was visit from a plastic cup, the villagers, the people in slum coming back to giving me in a glass or a steel glass to drink fruity or Coca-Cola or something. So this is how they started understanding. And you know, a lot of people came and told us that, ma'am, everyone talks about don't use plastic, beat plastic pollution. It's worldwide, it's become a thing that everyone talks. But who is on ground going to tell us that what is it that if you don't use this, don't use this? So with advocacy, you also need groundwork. You see, not all of us across India can go on to Google. Half of the time we had prepaid SIM cards. We don't have internet all the time. True, so where are we going to read? So we also need. So, you know, it's like when you're sitting with somebody and face to face, you're telling someone, that person has gone and told 20 more people, ki, okay, you know, let's not use this, let's use this. That is what Misal India started doing in most of the areas we worked in. And then we also expanded to so many different areas, because I think people from all over India started getting in touch with us that can we do, because earlier people were saying that in a country like India, where there are bigger problems, do you think you need to color the slums? So when they understood that it was not just about coloring the slum, because I myself very strongly believe ki right now we don't need to color the slum. You go into a slum, you go into a village, there are much, much bigger issues that needs to be sorted first. Like earlier when we went our first Jafar Baba slum in Bandra, I went with my buckets and started coloring. Few people came and said, ma'am, aap color kar rahe ho, isse acha hame paise de do, hum school fee bhar denge, hum medical assistant le lenge apne bachchon ke paas ke liye. You know, all these things. And they are very genuine issues.
Yeah.
And, you know, I explained to them that we are not going to just color and run off. We will address these issues also. Give us some time. Join us. So I painted and transformed, waterproofed, cleaned 20 homes. We had 200 people standing behind us, coming out of curiosity to see what's going on. You know, rather than me going home to home and my team going home to home and saying that, okay, let's tell us if your kid is going to school, if the youth is educated, hope you're not using plastic. I think people would have just shut doors on us. They saw that something nice is happening. Okay, let's go and see what is happening. And that is when, you know, they came forward, joined hands. And when they understood that there is no, she's not here to take anything back from us. She's here and her team is here to give something to us, add value in whatever way into our lives. I think that is when Misal Mumbai became Misal India and became one big family. So I think this was the initial part was a little tougher because, you know, when you go to a slum or you go to an area where you have not worked before, people are a little apprehensive about who's coming. Is there a political party? Is there a builder involved? Is it some kind of scam which is happening? Again, they are marking our homes or something like that. So, you know, you peacefully address their issues because that is something they have probably faced in the last 30, 40 years. I mean, there are people who are living, the third generation is living in that slum. So you have to give it to them that, you know, they face these issues. So that's why they get scared. And that is when you kind of peacefully, you know, explain and take things forward. So God has been extremely kind. I think people have been extremely welcoming. And when they understood, they have welcomed us with open arms. And I think that is most satisfying.
But I feel these are more challenges, you know, Rubal. I mean, judging you and then coming in the way and then asking you every time. I think these are the good challenges. Because these are actually changing their belief systems. You've actually changed their belief systems. You know, coming down to Rubal, you know, you've hosted more than 100 exhibitions, you know, when it comes to art. And abhi bhi there are so many artists who really don't know how to go forward. You know, now this question is from the people who are actually looking forward. They are, you know, they're not from well-to-do family. Wo itne acche ghar se nahi hai, but wo artist hai, unko aage kaam karna hai. What do you have to tell? What are the ways where they can, you know, move forward? Because a lot of parents, बहुत सारे parents मना कर देते हैं, you know, when it comes to creativity, वो कहते हैं यार ये पैसा नहीं देगा, you know, जब तक कोई पैसा नहीं देगा कैसे आप इसमें आ सकते हो? So what is the message for them, for the budding artists who are looking to come in this field and join?
Sushak, Hina, you know, I have been asked this question many times, that how do these youngsters see art as a career? I would just say one thing, that art is a career with a lot of patience. I'm sure most of the career you need to have patience. You start from a smaller level, then you get to a managerial job, then you get to CEO, and then you become MD, and then, you know, vice president and president. You have to grow up. You have to grow in a system slowly. And, you know, when I was in Kolkata, my dad was posted there. One of my teacher, you know, said, you know, we were talking about art and culture and this and that. She said it was an old saying in West Bengal that when a child was very notorious and wouldn't listen to his mother, mother would say, I will make you an artist when you grow up if you don't listen to me. That means I'm finishing your career options.
Yeah.
So, you know, that was the mindset in those days, but not anymore. I see a lot of youngsters opting for art as a career. I see, and we have such amazing art universities, art and craft universities, colleges across India. I mean, there are thousands of names, hundreds of names I can give you. Tamil Nadu has, Andhra Pradesh has, Madhya Pradesh has, Bombay has, Delhi has, Gurgaon. I mean, everywhere you have these amazing. Hyderabad, I went to the Architecture and Art College and I think it was amazing. And I cannot tell you some of the most amazing pieces of art I have seen during my interaction with all the MFA students there. And it is amazing. But this is not a career you think. You know, youngsters, they get a little impatient at times. I tell them that, you know, it's not that your first show didn't work means your other shows will not work. So if your first show works, great. It gives you a lot of moral boost to go forward and do more shows. But if your first show doesn't move the way you want it to, then learn from it and work harder and create more beautifully for your next show. Don't get disheartened. Don't be heartbroken. Oh, mere pehle show mein paintings nahi biki. Because I'm telling you, some of the artists, they don't even have money to buy canvases, colors, book a gallery, then invite people. It's a big expense. And some of the galleries today are charging 70,000, 80,000, 1 lakh plus. Exactly. Where are these artists going to get that money from?
Exactly.
So, you know, that kind of also pulls a lot of Indian artists back that, you know, how are we going to do it? Well, I do support a lot of artists. I have done in past also. My focus has always been on handicapped artists more. I have a student, not a student anymore, I would say a family member who lives in Lucknow. She doesn't have both her arms. She was very small when she met with an accident, and she paints with her toes. And we held her exhibition in Bombay, and it was a sold out show. And I still remember in the evening after the event was done, she said, "Ma'am, the show is on for 5 days. What are we going to show tomorrow?" And she was crying. I said, "You don't have to pack your bags. Go. Why are you here? Just go enjoy Bombay for 2-3 days and just go have fun." So like that, I have my first focus would be on handicap artists, because for them it's a little more longer struggle and more hard work. But then of course, when I see some really, really talented artists also, I kind of put in my hands in that. But as you know, I've now limited myself to that, because I don't get time and I don't do anything in life which I'm not been able to give 100% to. You know, I would only pick up an art project or an area to work in, or even a person I want to take forward in any career of his or her life, is when I truly believe in that project. You know, believe in that person, that this person is ready to work hard, not going to worry about the rain, not going to worry about the 40 degrees, but is still ready to, you know, meri skin kharab ho jayegi ya mere haath pair kharab ho jayenge, mere kapde kharab ho jayenge. No, if you are ready to be what it takes to be, then we are ready to work together. Even my team is very driven. You know, Hina, there are times when my senior people are working with me on site and picking up buckets and giving it, jhadu laga rahe hain, koi kya bolte hain, wo cement ko saaf kar raha hai. So a lot of other people are like, "Ma'am," and I tell them, I said, "You guys leave it, the other guys will do it." "No, ma'am, you're doing it, how can we not do it?" So you know, if you are not showing what you are saying or what you believe in, others are not going to follow you. So you have to also show them the way, that you know, they know that this is the path she walks, so we have to walk with her. So you know, that also motivates the team a lot. So I guess that has always been a very inspiring point for all of us. And young artists, all I would say is, because we get a lot of emails, messages saying that guide us for what we need to take in future, we want all these private colleges are charging so much money. I always tell everyone, I say, we have such fantastic government colleges. I've studied in a government school and I think I turned out pretty okay. I might not be extremely well schooled. I might not speak the best of English or best of Hindi or any other language, Punjabi, that's like my language that we are grown up speaking. But when I want to put my point across, I make sure my language is understood by the person. I said, "Tum log utna bhi kar loge, to bhi life mein aage badh jaoge." So government colleges are amazing. Government universities are amazing. Why are these kids wanting to, you know, wanting to do something they cannot afford? And when you put your hands into something that you are not going, which you will not be able to sustain, you know, that is when the frustration also comes. That is where the depression comes. That is where the mental illness comes. That is where the youth gets demotivated. So government colleges are great. Go for it, because end of the day, what you learn on ground will also make a big difference in your career ahead. Private colleges are better than government colleges. Well, we have our disadvantages and advantages in both. But then if there is something which is going to not fit into your financial area of your parents, then why do we need to take that step? When government is giving you, midday meals are there, your free uniforms are there, you were paying absolutely zero. It's free education for children, primary education. So why not make use of that? Art has massive power, you know, to move people to a social change. And that is exactly what we are doing through Misal Mumbai and RNAF. Misal Mumbai, India and RNAF. So it is about keep, you know, I always tell youngsters, keep creating, think out of the box, because a single person is incapable of changing the world. But that person is able to continue the world that it needs to change through their action. So, you know, that is what our youth needs to understand today, that there are no fixed rules. You know, just go out there. We all know you have family pressures, you have financial pressures. There are a lot of reasons, accessibility, availability, poverty. There are a lot of reasons that will pull you down. But pick up that one reason to move forward. And that will really, you know, let you overcome so many different things. And for art, if you want to start art as a business, you know, I've taken down some points that what is that first step? Create great work. That is most important, because if you're not creating good work, it's not going to work. Get to know your target audience, because not everyone will like your work. Not everyone will hate your work. So don't get disheartened if somebody says, oh, your work is not good, because there will be 10 people who will come and say, wow, what fantastic work. You know, so you have to book your galleries. And today, luckily, in 21st century that we are in, you have a lot of art galleries. You have a lot of art educators. You have a lot of people who are also guiding you, art experts, that, okay, this is your work. So this is the kind of, you know, timeline you should have for your work, that you start painting, take so many months or years or whatever, and then book this gallery and then go like this. So there are a lot of people who are actually teaching you today how to go about your career in art. We are doing that too. You can write to us and we will write back to you. We speak to a lot of students. My team, my senior team members speak and guide them as well. When I can, I do it too. So there, it's not that art is not a booming market. I mean, earlier and what you see today, our Indian artists are selling for a few millions. And but it's the career which needs patience. You need to have patience.
I think it needs persistence. It needs a lot of...
Absolutely. Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think not just art, a lot of other professions are like that. But if we talk about art, as we're talking about art, I think these are few basic things that our youngsters need to keep in mind.
So, Rubal, coming to being a mother, you know, how old is Ivan? You know, you've been holding, you've held what, more than 100 exhibitions across the world. How do you manage being a mother and, you know, being a professional, you know, going out? What is the relationship that you share with your son?
Well, I think my son is my best friend. It was my husband earlier, but now he's taken over that seat for life. So, and he's 8 and a half. I could do those 150 exhibitions worldwide because Vivan wasn't born at that time. And you know, my life after Vivan is born has, I would say, shifted to a different side of work 90%. Earlier I was doing more of art and running the foundation, educating children through art. And 8.5-9 years back, I think I decided that now it's full-time groundwork. Earlier I wasn't on ground every day, but now I'm on ground every day. Yes. So I think that positivity and that, you know, that let's do it kind of thing happened also after Vivan. And he, from the time he was born, I mean, I delivered him 2-3 days after I installed one of my public art installation on in Bombay, and one of my friend was crossing the road and in the car, and she called me. She said, "Is that you all fat going to deliver the baby standing on a 4 feet height and doing wow. some work?" I said, "Well, yeah, that's me." And she's like, "Go home now. I mean, can I send you something to eat, something to drink?" I said, don't worry. I would be very happy to deliver here while working, but let's talk a little more sane. Don't worry, I'm fine." So I think there is nothing that a mother can't do. I mean, a child doesn't make you handicapped. A child gives you more strength to work harder, more strength to connect to more children and to people around the world, because it's a very emotional bond. And I've always had that emotional bond with all the children that I've worked with past 15 years. Because for me to start my NGO was because of children. You know, Bhina, I have to share this. When I did my first art camp with the Pratham Foundation, and you know, I'm very involved. That was my first time on ground with another foundation. And I had no clue that, okay, you know, I wanted to do good work. So I said, "Let's do the art camp and, you know, let's see how it goes." So I was giving papers, pencils, colors, and I gave pencil to one of the child, this, I think, 4.5, 5-year-old kid. And he said, "What do I do with this?" In Hindi, he said, you know. So I said, "You don't know what you do with pencil." He said, "What is it?" So, you know, I still get goosebumps. And I'm like, okay, we are in Mumbai. We are not even like some remote area where kids have not seen pencils. I say, "You really don't know what a pencil is?" He said,
"And this is how long? This is, I mean, you're talking
about
which
year?" This is 2007-8. So not even like,
yeah,
40 years back when I was born, you know, it's not even that. So I was, so you know, that is the time I sat there and I said, "Ye pencil hai, isse aap draw kar sakte ho, apna naam likh sakte ho." He said, "Mujhe likhna nahi aata." So I wrote his thing, and then I spoke to the team and they said, "Ma'am, we've just got his admission done in the school and he's coming to the Balwadi to study." So now that child is a different child. I mean, we don't recognize that child anymore. He's amazing. And I was like, you know what, which world are we living in? Where kids still don't have access to pencils and they don't know what a pencil is. I think that changed my complete thinking process. My thought process completely changed. And then I did multiple camps. We took kids to Lonavala, interacted with kids there. Because for me to start anything or put my hands into anything, I need to understand where I'm going. Because just saying that I love children and I want to take kids to school will not make me take kids to school. Absolutely. You have to channelize that, okay, yeah. How are you going to make an initiative that will take so many children to school, and what is the impact that you're doing this work? But if your work doesn't have impact, it's not going to make any sense. So that is when I, you know, did a couple of workshops, a couple of art camps, understood the ground reality of what needs to be done and how this needs to start functioning. Is when I started my Balwadis, I started my learning centers and started the foundation. That, okay, now I think it's time. But after my son, I think I completely soaked myself into social work. And Misal, of course, then also connected me to millions of people across India. I mean, I don't remember meeting, I'm not someone who goes out, you know, meeting everyone. And I think Misal has connected me in last 2.5 years to millions of people, just because I'm on ground, you know, there morning to evening working with them. There are times that I have slept in the slums because they're my family, and I've, you know, it's like late, it's late, aap kaam kar rahe ho, late ho gaye. I tell the mausi, I said, "Mausi, aaj idhar hi so jaate hain," and they're like, "Madam, aap so jo." I said, "Of course, you can sleep. Why can't I sleep? I just put one chatai and I'll sleep with you, na. I'll be very happy." "Madam, pani nahi aata." I said, "Aap ek chota bucket mere liye bhar ke rakh do. That's okay. In the morning, I'll go freshen up and come back." So it's amazing. It's you know, kind of given a new direction to my life. So being a mother is beautiful. He is a wonderful child and very, very understanding, very intelligent. And he, you know, once he was asked in his school that teachers were asking every child that, "Okay, what does your mama do?" It was, I think, Mother's Day or something, they were celebrating about empowering women. So my son stands up and says, because most of the teachers we interacted, they know what I do. They said, my mother is an artist and she goes to slums and cleans garbage. So everybody started laughing and everybody started clapping because he was so honest. He could have said she's a social worker or activist. He said, no, she goes to slums and cleans garbage.
And she paints,
and she paints them. Because he's come with me to slums so many times. You know, I take him, the last 3 years, he's been celebrating his birthday in every different slum of mine. With the children there, he's got friends there, and you know, he invites them home. He goes and spends time with them whenever he can. So they're my children. He's my biological child, but they are my emotional children. I mean, I'm emotionally mother to them. So there's no difference between them and Vivans. So I guess that has been a very cute part of me being a mother. And I think it has taught me a lot of patience, a lot of more love to give. You know, sometimes you kind of hold back your love, but after you're a mother, you're all out there to give and spread joy, spread love. So I guess that was, I'm very thankful to God for that.
When you walk your talk and, you know, all of this goes back to your bringing up, you know, you, the way you've been brought up. How did you meet Sahil? You know, you got married at 19. I want to know, being in the army, being from the army background, what is the story of meeting Sahil and then getting married at 19? 19 is when, you know, the girls were thinking what to do and probably were really not thinking of marriage.
But listen, I wasn't thinking, no, that's why I got married. So, basically, my dad was posted in Kolkata, and that's where my art journey also started in Shantiniketan. But Sahil, being a Bombay boy, he was born and brought up in Bombay. And, you know, in army, you have a lot of friends. So, one of my friend, Girish, Sahil was his friend. And I think at one of the birthday parties, we met each other and we liked each other. And then I guess, you know, it's like so many years back. I don't even remember what happened then. But my husband says, you know, it took me 1 year to understand what you liked, what you didn't like. I said, listen, in school days, I liked everything. He said, no. Out of all your seven, because we were a group of seven friends called Spectrum in my 11th and 12th standard in Kolkata. And he was friends with all those girls. And he used to come and go. You know, he used to visit Kolkata for his work. And they also have a home there, his mother being Bengali. So they used to travel a lot. So he used to keep bumping into each other, but like a casual note. But he was friends with all my girlfriends, and they used to really like him, that he's such a gentleman, he's such a well-read person, very, very down to earth, nice guy. So
was he an artist too? Did he like the artwork?
No. Or he art collector, not an artist, but they collected a lot of art. I mean, his house has some amazing pieces of art, but yes, a lot of knowledge about art. And I think that is when the creative part was something that got us both talking to each other, because I somehow cannot have conversation with somebody who just doesn't talk beyond a point. You know, even when I was in 11, 12, I had a mind of you can say 10 years ahead of my time age-wise. So with him, when I sat, we spoke about art, culture, different cities, what's happening around the world. I was like, okay, after so long, I've met someone who can actually have a sensible conversation. And I think that is when we started talking to each other. And one day he just popped up the question saying that, okay, should we get married? Because your dad is getting posted, you're going to Kashmir border. And I was like, let me pass my 12th, do my graduation. He said, why? You can do everything after marriage. I'm not going to say no for anything. And I was like, okay, let's get married. And that's when it happened. Wow. And you know, you will not believe, before I met him, like a year before I met him, I was telling my dad, I said, because dad used to get a lot of rishtas for me. So I said, dad, do not even think till I'm 27, 28. And then when I went to my dad said, did we not have a chat a year back saying that? I said, dad, it's okay. But he's saying, we don't even know what is there. You know, then we got the background, families met. It wasn't an easy thing. My father was not ready in the beginning. He didn't want to just, you know, get married so early, being the only daughter with two elder brothers. But I think what is meant to happen. And I think that was one of the best decisions I took at 19. And I'm so thankful to God for that, because he's very instrumental in my journey. And he's been extremely supportive from the time I started, you know, till now. Extended support with open arms and said, whatever I can, you know, you just tell me, but I wanted to do something, you know, in my life on my own terms and starting absolutely from the grassroots level. And I think that is why the respect factor is huge today. And he proudly says that, you know, she could have chosen a different life, but she's done everything of her own. And we are all, the whole family is very proud of her. And I think that is very important. A good partner in your life is a big support system. Absolutely. And is very, very instrumental. I think that is how the Sahil Nagi journey happened.
So Rubal, where do you see your foundation, Misal Mumbai, you know, in few years? You know, you being a very proud Indian, you know, you being into CSR activity, and I see that as a passion. You know, you don't do it to show somebody or to prove somebody. You know, you don't do that. So where do you see yourself? You know, what is your vision in life?
Well, I would say that, as I said, when I say my foundation mission, that includes my mission also, is that I want to see our country 100% literate. Hamare desh ka har ek bachcha, har ek nagrik, har ek mahila educated ho, shikshit ho, that is what we want. And when I say education does not mean just getting an academic year certificate, going to a college, completing a degree. When I say educated, it means you understand basics of your society, empowering your women, respecting your elders, you know, supporting each other and holding hands and moving forward. Self-reliant India. And that will happen when we all believe in ourselves, we believe in our country. And through foundation, that is what we are going to do. Through Misal India, we have still few states left that we need to reach. And we are getting a lot of queries from other countries, from outside India. So we are also on talks of taking Misal model to different parts of the world now. If COVID didn't happen, probably we would have started work in one of the countries already. But nevertheless, next year, God willing, if everything is fine, we will start. But my focus remains India. But we will definitely expand, because with taking Misal India model outside the country, a lot of international countries will understand India more. You know, understand what is happening in the slums and villages and how things are functioning there, how people are, what are the problems people are facing there, how people are living there. So I guess for me to take the Misal India initiative out of India is not to only empower their city, that slum, that village, their that area, but it's also to give a message as an Indian that, see, the problem that you're facing, a lot of these problems are similar to the problems we face in our country. So let's join hands together and fight it together instead of criticizing and, you know, getting onto negative energy. Let's work towards a common goal of humanity. And that is where things will become positive. So I think that is what Misal will do into the thing. Because, you know, the main aim of Misal Mumbai is not about coloring the walls. I always say colors will fade in few years. But the positive change we want to bring in people's mind will stay forever. They will understand the importance of educating their children, educating girl child, empowering their women, letting them work, empowering their youth, cleanliness, hygiene, sanitation, waste management, proper health. Because when you're addressing these issues, your health kind of improves in the slums as well. So these are the basics of our initiative Misal India, that we kind of, you know, logon se art ke madhyam se logon se judna, connecting to people through art, bringing that change through art. Art ke madhyam se unhe shikshit karna is what our aim is. And I think this is what we are going to do for next. We have a 5-year target. We have a number of 2 million kids that we want to touch in next 2 years to take to school and come join our Balwadis and learn with us. And we have a very unique way of teaching in our Balwadi. It's not the regular way of reading. Our teachers are amazing. They play. They teach them more mentally than to just read and write on the books. So there are different techniques. That's why the number of children has really increased in last 6 years with us. Because, you know, and it's very important that, you know, you kind of keep the child engaged in whatever they're learning. And, you know, if you're teaching and the child is not learning, it has no meaning. And every child learns in a different way. So we have to teach. Our teachers have to be trained to teach that child in a language the child is going to understand. That very is very, very important. Yeah. And at times, you know, I see in some of the schools the teachers are teaching and some children are getting it and some children are not getting it. And every child is different. So teachers have to make sure that the language they teach the children is something that is understood by them as well. And I think that is what we stress a lot in our Balwadis, in our learning centers, where we interact with kids one-on-one also. That is why one hour session is not more than 35 to 40 kids. When we have like 300-400 children in that one area, we divide it into, but 35 to 40 kids at one go, not more than that, because then the teacher can give attention to all those 35 and 40. So that is very, very important. And that is where we see ourselves going in the next few years.
Very well said. And you know, I wish you all the best. I wish the foundation all the best. And I, you know, the way you're spreading happiness, the way you're spreading education, the way you're empowering individuals is amazing. Thank you so much for joining.